Hello friends, this is the series of geography videos which we are making. I hope you should have already seen our previous geography video, which is the Kaveri River Basin, which we have already made and published. Now in this video, we are going to see Ganga Basin, and this Ganga Basin is to be covered in four video classes. And in this four series of video classes, we are going to cover Ganga, its tributaries, important cities on these tributaries, as well as personalities associated with these tributaries, historical aspects of these personalities. We are going to see the GI tags and other aspects of this river basin. So please watch all the four videos which we are going to make on this Ganga River Basin. Let us go deep into the slides now. Let us try to understand some basic features of the river Ganga. See, Ganga or Ganges is a transboundary river which flows through India and Bangladesh. It has got its origin in Gangotri Glacier in Uttarakhand, and the length of this river Ganga is 2525 kilometers. Ganga, along with Brahmaputra river system, is the third largest river system in the world as far as discharge is concerned. The other salient features of this river Ganga is that one of the important tributaries, Yamuna, is joining Ganga in a place which is called Allahabad. There it makes something which is called Triveni Sangamam. We will see more about this Allahabad and Triveni Sangamam in the subsequent slides. And also you must know that river Ganga system forms the world's largest delta, which is the Sundarban Delta. Ganga Basin covers four countries. This include India, Nepal, China and Bangladesh. Ganga Basin also covers 11 states in India. This include Himachal Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana, Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Bihar, West Bengal, and also of course the Union Territory, New Delhi. Let us try to see the tributaries of this river Ganga. The left bank tributaries of river Ganga include Ram Ganga, Gomati, Ghagra, Gandak, Kosi and Mahananda. The right bank tributaries include Yamuna, Tamsa, San, Punpun, etc. The right and left bank tributaries of a river has to be understood by going along with the river system. When you travel along with this river system, you flow along with this water. What are the tributaries which are coming in the left are considered to be the left bank tributary. Those tributaries which are coming and joining you in the right hand side are considered to be the right bank tributaries. The distributaries of river Ganga include Hooghly, Padma and Ajay. Let's see the important cities which are located on the banks of this Ganga river system. These cities include Rishikesh, Haridwar, Kannauj, Kanpur, Allahabad, Varanasi, Patna, Murshidabad and Kolkata. Now we will try to understand one by one this important cities, and we will flow along with these cities in trying to understand about the river. And we have to know there is a river which is called Bhagirathi, which rises in Gangotri Glacier, and there is another river which is called Alaknanda. Both this Bhagirathi and Alaknanda, they confluence in a place which is called Devprayag, and from Devprayag, these two rivers subsequently they take the name which is called Ganga. So Alaknanda, Bhagirathi, they join in a place which is called Devprayag. From there it takes the name which is called Ganga. Ganga flows through Rishikesh in the mountain valleys and finally reaches the plain in a place which is called Haridwar. Let us try to understand something about the place which is called Rishikesh. Rishikesh is the yoga capital of the world, and also it is the gateway to the Garhwal Himalayas. Rishikesh is famous for Ayurvedic treatments, and also it is famous for rafting, which is a very popular sport here. We'll see more points about Rishikesh. It is in Rishikesh that the first Ayush center was opened by government in 2015. Ayush means Ayurveda, Yoga, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy. And Rishikesh is also the starting point of Chota Chadram pilgrimage, which starts in a place which is called Rishikesh, and it covers all these places: Badrinath, Kedarnath, Gangotri and Yamunotri. Let us try to see about Haridwar. Haridwar is one of the holiest of the places associated with Hindu religion. Ganga enters the plains in Haridwar, and Haridwar is also a place of Kumbh Mela. I will speak more about Kumbh Mela etc. in the subsequent slides. and the Puranic name of Haridwar is Maya. This question had been already asked sometime back in UPSC. And this city which is called Haridwar is mentioned by Huang Xuang. I hope you all know Huang Xuang is a Chinese pilgrimage who had come to India and visited India during the time of Harshavardhana in the 6th to 7th century AD. It is in this place that Gurukul Patsala had been started by Arya Samajist in the year 1902. Arya Samaj, which was founded in the year 1875, has been pioneering in the field of inculcating education in India. They started Dayananda Anglo-Vedic School in a place which is called Lahore in the year 1886, and they also started Gurukul Patsala, which is a traditional way of Indian education, in Haridwar in the year 1902. Haridwar is also home to IIT Roorkee, and you must know it is one of the oldest institutions which had been established in India. It is the oldest engineering college which has been established in India in the year 1847. And also you must know there is a place which is called Rajaji National Park is found around this place. Next we'll see something about Rajaji National Park. Rajaji National Park is also a tiger reserve. It is located in Shivalik Hills of the Himalayas, and the notable species here happens to be tiger, Asiatic elephant, leopard, etc. Let us try to understand one more thing about a GI tag associated with Uttarakhand. In Uttarakhand, we have a GI which is called Uttarakhand Tejpat. This is the Uttarakhand Tejpat. Uttarakhand Tejpat is an Indian bay leaf. This leaf is added in cooking, and this leaf not only gives flavor but also it possesses medicinal properties, and it is because of this that this leaf had been given a GI tag. Let's travel along with River Ganga and see Kannauj. Kannauj had been mentioned in Mahabharata and Ramayana as Kanyakumja. It is a very important ancient Indian city, and Kannauj happens to be the capital of a ruler who is called Harshavardhana. Harshavardhana ruled the dynasty which is called Pushyabhuti dynasty. It is in this Harshavardhana's court that Huang Xuang, a Chinese pilgrimage, had visited and stayed for a long duration of time. And you must know, Kannauj remained the focal point for fighting between the three important dynasties who are called as Pratiharas, Palas, Rashtrakutas. The fight to occupy this Kannauj by these three important dynasties led to something which is called a tripartite struggle. And you must know, it is this tripartite struggle which weakened all the three dynasties, and almost the whole of North India politically had weakened. And this is a very important factor for the incoming of the Turks in the 10th, 11th century in India. Let us try to understand GI tag associated with Kannauj. Kannauj is known for Kannauj perfume, and this Kannauj perfume is also known as Kannauj Idhar. It is a traditional Indian perfume. For information, Kannauj is known as the perfume capital of India. Let's go to the other important city, which is called Kanpur. It is the second largest city in the state of Uttar Pradesh after Lucknow. And you must know, it is in Kanpur where a revolt of 1857 was very important. So the revolt center during this time happens to be Kanpur in 1857. And I hope you should remember the name Nana Saheb, who was a revolutionary who fought during the revolt of 1857 from a place which is called Kanpur. And Kanpur is also known for leather industries and hosiery garments. Kanpur also houses IIT Kanpur, which is existing here. Let us try to see the GI tag associated with Kanpur. Kanpur Saddlery is a GI tag which has been allotted, and you must know Kanpur is the only place not only in India but the whole of Asia where this saddlery had been made. I have given an image of this saddlery and you must just see. And this saddlery, Kanpur Saddlery GI tag, had been given in the year 2014. Next we will travel to Allahabad. Allahabad had been referred in ancient India as Kausumbi, and it is also referred as Prayag or the place of offering. It is one of the oldest living cities in India after Varanasi. It is in Allahabad that the national waterway number 1 originates. It connects Allahabad and Haldia. Let us try to understand something about national waterway in the next slide. See, these are the basic facts about the national waterway. There are 111 officially notified inland national waterways, and it covers the distance of approximately 20,275 kilometers, and among which there are three national waterways which are in operational, which I am going to speak. National waterway number 1, it connects Allahabad and Haldia, and the approximate distance is 1,620 kilometers. National waterway number 2, is connecting Sadia and Dubri on the Brahmaputra river system, which is having 891 kilometers. National waterway number 3 is in Kollam and Kozhikode, which is the West Coast Canal, which is in Kerala. So these are the three important waterways which are existing right now. Allahabad is also the city of prime ministers. It is known as the city of prime ministers because you must know, out of 16 prime ministers as of today, 7 prime ministers had come from this city, Allahabad. They include Jawaharlal Nehru, Gulzarilal Nanda, Lal Bahadur Shastri, Indira Gandhi, Rajiv Gandhi, VP Singh and Chandrasekhar. And let us try to understand something about Allahabad historically. In Allahabad, we have got a pillar which is called Allahabad Pillar Inscription. This pillar, Allahabad pillar, had been installed by the great emperor Ashoka, who belongs to the Mauryan dynasty. So in this pillar, Ashoka had written something which is called edict. This edict had been written in Brahmi script. And in this Allahabad pillar inscription, Ashoka had given instruction to the people through this edict. And Allahabad pillar inscription is also very important because it is not only consisting of Ashokan inscription. Later on, the subsequent rulers who had come, they also wrote something in this same pillar which is existing. And also we see a ruler who is called Samudragupta, who belongs to Gupta dynasty, had written about his achievements and conquest in the same Allahabad pillar. And later on, the Mughal emperor Jahangir also wrote something about his administration in this Persian language in the same Allahabad pillar inscription. So the Allahabad pillar inscription is known for these three important rulers and their times. And you must know, Allahabad is also a place where Akbar had built a fort, which is a red fort of Akbar was built in Allahabad. Akbar is known to have established four important forts in different places, which is in Allahabad, Agra, Ajmer and Lahore. Allahabad in history in modern India can be traced some of the features. You must know there is a treaty which is called Treaty of Allahabad, which was signed in the year 1765. This treaty is very, very important because this treaty was signed after the Battle of Buxar, in which the British emerged victorious. In this Battle of Buxar, the British defeat the ruling house of Bengal, the ruling house of Awadh. Both these houses, along with the Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II, the three powers were defeated in this Battle of Buxar. After defeating these rulers in the Battle of Buxar, the British get this Treaty of Allahabad signed by Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II. It is in this Treaty of Allahabad that Shah Alam II gives the right of Diwani in Bengal, Bihar and Orisha to the Britishers, after which they established the dual government in Bengal. So let us not go very deep into this history. Sufficient to know that this is a place associated with the Treaty of Allahabad in 1765. And also you must know Chandrasekhar Azad, who happens to be a revolutionary terrorist of phase 2. Phase 2 means 1920s to 30s. During this time, Chandrasekhar Azad was a prominent personality, and this place Allahabad is associated with his death because Chandrasekhar Azad had been betrayed by his friend and he had been surrounded by the British in a place which is called Alford Park, which is located in Allahabad. Finally, unable to escape, he shot himself dead. He committed suicide in the year 1931 in Allahabad. Today the park is named after him as Azad Park. And you must know, in Allahabad also, Nehru family has got a long tradition history. Because we have Anand Bhavan, which happens to be the traditional house of the Nehrus, is located. And also we have Suraj Bhavan, both are present in Allahabad. Allahabad is also a very important place, you must know, because it is in Allahabad that we have something which is called Triveni Sangamam, are the confluence of three important rivers. These three rivers include Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati. And we all know these two rivers which they confluence. And it is believed that Saraswati, it merges with these two rivers from underground. So Triveni Sangamam is a place where Ganga, Yamuna and the mythical river which is Saraswati is believed to have merged here. And also you must know, this Allahabad is the place where the ashes of our father of nation Mahatma Gandhi is immersed in 1948. And let us come to the point which I have already spoken before, which is the Kumbh Mela. Kumbh Mela is a mass Hindu pilgrimage and it is a gathering where many Hindu pilgrimage from different parts of India come and congregate. And a mass Kumbh Mela or a Kumbh Mela is held in Triveni Sangamam in Allahabad. Let us try to see one or two points about this Kumbh Mela. You must know, Every 3 years, we have a normal Kumbh Mela which is held. Every 6 years, we have a Kumbh Mela which is called Ardh Kumbh Mela or Half Kumbh Mela, which is held in a place which is called Haridwar and Allahabad. And you must know, every 12 years also, we have Purna Kumbh Mela, which is a complete Kumbh Mela, which is held in these four places, which is Allahabad, Haridwar, Ujjain and Nasik. And every 144 years, we have Maha Kumbh Mela, which is held in this place, which is called Allahabad. Let us try to see the GA tag associated with Allahabad. There is something which is called Allahabadi Sukha. Allahabadi Sukha is a special variety of Goa. This is special because unlike the traditional Goa which has got white interior, this Goa has got a deep pink color inside and it is very tasty, and because of which it has got a GA tag. So we have come to the end of part 1 of our series. So as I already told you, we are making 4 videos associated with Ganga river system and we are coming to the end of part 1. So for the part 2 and other things, please keep updated with our videos. So we'll be uploading part 2 videos in a short duration of time. Also, please watch our videos of Kaveri and other historical videos which are available in the internet.